Hello friends, my name is Tushar and today I'm going to talk about topological sort. So given a directed acyclic graph, topological sort is the ordering of vertices of this graph such that for every edge uv going from u to v, u should always appear before v in the ordering. So for this graph here, one topological sort could be a, b, c, e, d, f, g. Another ordering could be b, d, a, c, e, f, and g. So the point here is that c should never be before a and b in the ordering, or d should never be before b, or e should never be before c, and so on. So one of the application of topological sort is in the build system. Suppose these were the packages of a build system saying that C has a dependency on A and B package, and D has a dependency on B, and E has a dependency on C, and so on. So how would the build system know that which package it should build first? So what it does is it builds a graph of the packages and then applies a topological sort on them, like create one of this ordering, and then builds the builds the packages in this order. So A and B build first, so C has a dependency on A and B, so then C can go next, and then E and D can go next, and F can go next, and G can go next, and so on. So in the next section, let's see how we are going to do topological sorting. So we have two data structures, a set and a stack. Set has all the visited vertices, while stack has all the vertices in topologically sorted order. So what we're going to do is we're going to start from any node. So let's say we started from E. So first thing we do is E is not in a visited set, so we put E into the visited set. So we put it here. Then we are going to explore the child of E, children of E. So we go in the direction of H. So H is not visited, so we put H into the visited set. And then we are going to explore the children of H. H has no children, it means that H has been totally explored. At that point, we put it into the stack. So only when a vertex has been totally explored, it means that all its children have been explored. At that point, you put that vertex into the set. So we put H into this stack. Then we go back to E, and then E has other child F, and F is not in this visited set. So first we put it into this visited set, and then we go to F, and then F has a child G. So, and G is not in the visited set, so we first put it in the visited set and then go to G. And then at this point, G doesn't have any children. So G is, we are done exploring G, so we are going to put G into this sorted stack. So we'll put G into this stack. And then we go back to F, and then F has no children, no more child to explore. So we're going to put F into the stack. And then we go back to E. At this point, E has explored all its children, so we're going to put E into the stack. So now, what we're going to do is we're going to pick any other vertex which is not visited. So let's say we picked B. So first thing we do is we put B into the set. Then we explore a child of B. So let's say we picked C. C is not in the set, visited set. So we're going to put C into the set and then explore the children of C. C has one child, E, and E is already into the visited set, so we don't do anything. And then C has no other child. At this point, we put C into this stack. And then we go back to B. B has another child, D, and D is not in the visited set, so we put D into the visited set. And then we go to D, and D has a child F, which is already in a visited set, so we don't go there, and we stay at D, and D has no more child to explore, so we put D into this stack. And then we go back to B. At this point, B has explored both its children, so we are done exploring B, so we put B into the stack. And at this point, let's pick another unvisited node. So the only unvisited node at this point is A, so we go to A and put A into this visited set, and then explore child of A, which is C. C is already into this visited set, so we don't do anything about it. Come back to A. A has no more children to explore, so we put A into this stack. So at this point, this stack has topologically sorted order of vertices of this graph. So it's A. We pop elements one by one from the stack A, B, D, C, E, F, G, H. Remember, there are multiple topological sort orders possible for this graph. It's just the order in which you pick this vertices, decide which one of them will show up. But all of them have this property that if a vertex, if there's a vertex U and V and going from U to V, U will always show up before V in this ordering. So in the next section, let's quickly look through
the code. So the main function is top sort. In this, I initialize a stack and a set. And then we start iterating through the vertices of this graph. Let's say the first vertex I encounter is D. So then I go into, so visitor doesn't contain D, so I go into top sort util. In the top sort util, the first thing I do is add D to the visited. Then I explore neighbors of D. So there is only one neighbor of D, which is F. And visitor doesn't contain F. So we go to top sort util again and go to the top of this top sort util in recursion. And again, we add F to the visited. And then we explore neighbors of F, and that F only has one neighbor G. And it also is not there in visited, so we don't go into this if condition. We go here, top sort util, again, top of this function, top sort util. And in there, we add G to the visited. Then we explore neighbors of G. G doesn't have any neighbor. So we are done exploring everything with G. So we put G into the stack. Then we roll back in recursion and we reach the top sort util where F was the vertex. And F is done exploring all its neighbors. So we add F to the stack. And then we roll back in recursion and similarly add D to the stack because D is done exploring all its neighbors. Then we go back to this top sort here in the for loop. Let's say we pick another vertex, say B. So B is not in the visited. So we again call top sort util with B. And then we go into top sort util. First thing we do is we add B into the visited and then explore neighbors of B. So let's say we explored C first. So C is not in the visited. So we call top sort util with C. And then we add C to the set, visited set. And then C, we explore C's neighbor. So C has a neighbor D. And D is already in the visited. So if we go continue and do not explore this neighbor at all. Go back to the top of the for loop for C. C doesn't have any more neighbors. So we break out of this for loop and we add C to the stack. Then we roll back in recursion and reach the point where vertex is B. B has, and we were in this for loop, B has another child E. So we, and E is not in the visited. So we call top sort util with E as a vertex and then go there. So first thing we do is we add E into the set, visited set. Then we explore neighbors of E. E has only one neighbor F and F is in the visited. So we do continue and then go back to the top of the for loop. At this point, E doesn't have any more neighbors to explore. So it comes here and adds E into the stack. Then we go back into the recursion to B. So B has done exploring both its neighbor in the for loop. So it goes here and adds itself into the stack. At this point, we go back to the top of this top sort. In here, we again iterate through vertices. If we encounter any other vertex other than A, then we'll just continue because they are all in the visited. As soon as we hit a vertex A, it's not in the visited, so we call top sort util. We call top sort util here. We add A to the visited. And then we explore neighbors of A. A has a neighbor C, but C is already in the visited, so we just do continue. At this point, A doesn't have any other neighbor to explore. So we go to the stack and add A to the stack. And then we go back to the top of top sort. Now we don't have any more vertex to explore. So we just return this stack. So all you have to do is pop elements out of the stack, and that's your topological sorted order. So let me write that quickly. A, B, E, C, D, F, and G. This is all I have to talk about topological sort. Please like this video, share this video, comment on this video. Check out my GitHub link, github.com, Mission Peace Interview Wiki. Check out my Facebook page. Thanks again for watching this video.